data are accessed directly by the CPU whenever CPU wants to process it. Next point is, this includes several types of memory such as processor cache and system ROM. These types we will see in the next slide. However, in most cases, primary memory refers to RAM. So, random access memory equivalent to primary memory. So, here we see that primary memory is of two types, RAM and ROM. RAM further divided into two types, SRAM and DRAM. ROM we will discuss in another video in detail. So, what is random access memory? RAM holds only those data and instructions on which the computer is currently working. For example, I am making a video. To make a video, we need a PPT, that is MS Office. So, that MS Office must be loaded into RAM. So, this point is very clear to you. Next point is, RAM is volatile. As I already told you, what is volatile and non-volatile? Whenever power is switched off, whatever the contents written on RAM are get lost. Next point is, it is random. What it means? It means we can read or store data randomly at any time and from any physical location. It is very beneficial point, because in earlier times magnetic tape is used to store the data, but we can read or store data in magnetic tape in an sequential order only. Next point is, these memories are limited in capacity. Whenever you see or compare with secondary devices like hard disk, you always see that the capacity of RAM is much more lesser. It is manufactured by using integrated circuit or semiconductor device. Based on semiconductor device, RAM is of two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. So, what is static RAM? Static RAM consists of flip-flops composed of 4 to 6 transistors. Here, flip-flop is the smallest unit to store one bit of information. The word static indicates that the memory retains its contents as long as power is being supplied. So, there is no need to refresh again and again. SRAM gives fast access but large in size. That's why it is primarily used in registers, which is used in CPU, and for cache memory. As we know, cache memory is the bridge between the primary memory and the CPU. We will discuss cache memory in detail in another video. Now, what is dynamic RAM? Dynamic RAM stores each bit in an electrical capacitor rather than in a flip-flop. Why it is dynamic? Because the memory must be constantly refreshed, otherwise it will lose its content. Why it is so? Because capacitor gradually leak charges. That's why DRAM is used for main memory in computing devices. Most of the DRAM used in modern system is synchronous DRAM, that is SDRAM. What is synchronous? This is part of computer organization. We will discuss it later on. Most of the manufacturers sometimes uses acronym DDR. Here, DDR stands for double data rate. It means how much data the memory can transfer in one clock cycle. That's why whenever we go to purchase the RAM, we always ask for the higher version of DDR. That is either DDR3 or DDR4. Because of the speed to transfer the data. That's all for today. Today we will learn primary memory and their types. After that we saw RAM and their types, that is SRAM and DRAM. There is a note, that is a computer cannot run without the primary memory. A computer can run without a secondary memory, but without primary memory, computer cannot run. Because for each application to run, that application must be moved from secondary device to main memory for execution by the CPU. In the next video, we will see the RAID only memory in detail, that is ROM. Thank you so much.